What's up, everyone? This is Elvestroyer 229, and welcome back to Let's Play Persona 3 FES. Last time, we did a little bit of prep work as we continue our exploration through the Abyss of Time. We bought some more equipment for our main party, we made a persona. And we did a little bit of reconnaissance, getting ahead of myself in my own words, in the Judeca block. I need to enunciate better. In this episode, we are heading back into the Judeca block, right when I talk about enunciation, and we are going to continue our exploration. Did a bit of reconnaissance, but now it's time that we went full force in exploration, or at the very least trying to find where the boss is. I mean, honestly, I can fight as many or as few enemies as I can. I think we're good to take on the boss. Well, we still haven't got an analysis yet on you.
Give me a sec.
Let's maybe fix that. Great choice. As I shoot these things with my new rifle. I mean, heck, if I can get an analysis off, that'd be great. And Metis can take out the Gygas. Okay. How does it do the wind? It repels wind.
The enemy's weak against ice.
Resists slash, drains pierce, nulls fire, repels wind, but weak to ice. Okay.
That one just won't die.
It mentioned nothing about electricity. So I will zap it.
All enemies defeated.
All right. And we get Kingu. I do have room for personas, but I'll take the swords. More quick pumps, I guess. Oh, stop. Thought that said Thor. Similar, the first three letters are the same. Not anything else, though. Alright, let's see if we can't just... I swear if that's another one of those stealth shirts, I'm going to be very upset. Well, whatever. At this point, I think I might just want to just... I might want to just charge to where the boss is. The more enemies I can fight, the better, but I do think that we are good as we are. And we get Ring of Serenity. Okay, an accessory, which is nice. Prevents you from being enraged. Okay. I can at least see a use for that. Because there were bosses, there was at least a boss, whose entire focus was to get us enraged. So if we fight another boss with a similar mechanic, that might come in handy. Alright, well, at any rate, still need to get through this, and I would like to at least fight as many enemies as possible. Even though I just said that we are looking good, we could always do a little bit more training. It can't hurt, and we're going to need it for future bosses anyway. Okay, and the Lustful Snakes, no fire and light, drains wind, but weak to ice.
I won't lose. Yukari-chan defeated.
Okay, so that's good to know. And Yukari's making quick work of them anyway. Okay, well, thank you, Junpei, for allowing me to take care of this one. So I can get shuffle time. Kali again. I may as well take the experience. Money would also be nice, but honestly, just getting more efficient with my training, there's Thor, would be even better. And he learns Gigantic Fist. Heavy strike damage. I suppose I could get rid of Zionga. Zionga was nice since it did allow me to save my SP. But really, aside for like training purposes and like getting through floors, I don't really need it. Hey, Titania leveled up too. And she gets Divine Grace. Huh? Again? Well, Ice Amp isn't exactly that great, so sure, what does it turn into this time? Resist the Light! Ooh, and Melchizedek leveled up too! And he also gets Mataru Kaja. Oh, what's it this time? Blade of Fury. No? I wanted him to have some sort of slash skill. If it was Heat Wave, then absolutely. But not Blade of Fury. I kind of want him to keep that. Alright, so moving onward. I can maybe find some more treasure. That would be nice, especially one that's helpful. Noble Seeker.
Give me a sec. I'll scan the target.
Okay, Thor is getting pretty close. Although, no, Chernabog isn't gonna do anything. It needs to be Garu skills. Which, I mean, there's Loki. I mean, I can still shoot it in the face.
Firing.
So that works. And then Metis can just beat the crap out of it. And she can continue to beat the crap out of them. As I get my analysis off. Now, hopefully this thing isn't weak to wind. Damn it! Oh well, I leveled up. Good to know. Bring Yukari here. Yukari is pretty awesome here. God dang it. That feeling when you're too strong that you can't do what you want to do. Because your allies just kill everything immediately. Like, oh, why don't you put him on wait then? Well, then the enemies will be able to beat the crap out of me. I want to soften him up, not just kill him outright. I was thinking about fighting that Minotaur again. But with it, oh, I can just walk right on by him. But with it only being weak to darkness, that's a little bit of a problem. Okay, I think we're good to take on... Yes, absolutely. And of course, it's another Minotaur. Wait, yes! Please be something actually good. A Serpent's Eye. Okay. Serpent's Eye prevents you from being frightened. Okay. Again, might be helpful when it comes to bosses. Because I might actually need that type of equipment. Heading back. Alright, It was good that I at least explored a little bit further, but I think it's time to move on. Alright. Fuga didn't give us any estimate as to where this boss would potentially be. Ooh, Kumbhahandra. I could certainly use a different persona. Ah, crap. Yeah! Still got him! Fusion fodder. Besides, at the very least, the more that I can get through this, the more likely I may actually just take on the boss as is. We're looking pretty alright in terms of our HP and SP. So I may actually want to consider doing that. At the very least, that'd be a boost to efficiency. Oh, normal chest. With a crusher fist. Actually, normal chests might actually have better things than rare chests. Which is a little hard to believe, but it seems to be what I keep finding. Oh, hey, speaking of which. Oh. Ow. I seriously need to get rid of Thoth. Anyway, what's in the rare chest this time? Oh my. Yukari! Let's see how this compares to your current shoes. Let's see. Sexy heels. Actually, better evasion and medium chance to evade fire. I'm sorry, Yukari. It's good armor, I swear. Alright, let's keep pressing onward then. I mean, to be fair, I was asking for helpful equipment, and it is helpful in terms of stats. At least I got what I wanted. It just happens to be at Yukari's expense. Ooh, hello, rare enemy. And not like I didn't notice that chest either. Come on, turn around. There are the stairs. Damn it, got him. All right, don't run away.
There's only one.
Got him!
Great.
Yes! A luxury coin! More money for me! Alright, and the chest has another crusher fist. Now I have two fists to give to Akihiko. Not punches, but straight up gloves. Alright, well, we're getting close. Fuga doesn't say how close. Alright, but at any rate, we're looking pretty alright. We're holding up extremely well against these enemies. Oh, hey, I might actually get an analysis off on these things. You know what? I can just shoot it.
You won't escape!
Okay, and there we go. Repels fire and light and dark, but weak to wind. So Yukari can just straight up murder that one, and then we can just rush the other one.
Let's keep going.
At least we got that analysis off. Don't really care too much for Os. Let's claim our wands, gain a lot of experience. And we can move ever onward. Damn it. At this point, I feel like I really need to be a little bit conservative when it comes to my SP. Because I think I will try to take on the boss when we get there. I mean, heck, if I don't have to come through here again, that's fine by me. Don't really need to come through here again. This is still a pretty decent way to get some experience. There's something down that way. What about over here? Where I need to go! Oh, crap. Rare enemies? Yes! Okay, I need to be quick because the Reaper shows up faster, but... Damn it, not again. Okay, I need to be quick, but I need to make sure that I can actually get them. I know I said I don't really need all that much money, but I'm not gonna say no if the game is kindly just handing me money. I mean, who'd say no to free money? Oh, come on, please turn around. I don't have time for this. No, seriously, the Reaper's gonna show up. There we go, that works. Damn it. Double damn it. There we go. Couldn't get that one. Oh well, whatever. You can't get all the rare enemies. But you can certainly try to get as many as you can. There you go. Damn it, I hate it when they run away immediately, giving you zero chance to actually try to get them. Well, whatever. Almost. There we go. At least I got him. Okay, found the stairs. Ooh, gotcha! And another one down, and another one down. Another gold hand for me. Alright. This one's risky. Still got it! I'm going to have so much money that I'll have no idea what to spend it on. I say that as if it isn't already a problem. Damn it. Well, he almost got away. But we still managed to get him. Alright, now I think that's gonna be the last of them. I think I've explored everywhere on this floor. A nice freebie floor. I love freebie floors. They're nice and free and allow me to get to my destination a whole lot quicker. Alright, well at least we've made it here to the 7th floor, and we are looking pretty alright. Everyone seems to be in good health. So let's go ahead and save. And who's currently out front? Chernabog, okay. Let's go ahead and have Thor out front. I do have Melchizedek in case I also needed him, but I only need one persona with an auto moss skill. Normally I'd head back, but I'd say we're good to go. Let's proceed. These guys look nasty. Although I'll admit, the tank looks pretty cool. So you have Slaughter Drive and the Spastic Turret. I mean, the fire paint job looks pretty nice. Unfortunately, the bunnies aren't on fire. Okay, so how do I want to do this? Well, I can at least see how they respond to electricity. Evade Elect! That tells me that Slaughter Drives are weak to electricity. Everything's neutral to slash, though. Or at the very least, resist if not neutral. They might all just resist slash. Ah, crap. Mind Charge. I don't even know what this thing is capable of. It also has a... Oh, no. Ah, crap. Oh, double crap! This is already looking bad. Okay. First things first, I need to get rid of these guys.
Keep it up.
Okay, I'll use another Zeodyne on this one. Damn it! Fire break. Interesting. So they aren't responsive to fire.
It's a tough one.
Oh, thank goodness, he used a Mind Charge Augudine on Junpei. A nice dodge, Junpei! Crap. Okay. Unfortunately, no one's really good with healing right now. So I will go ahead and heal up everyone. Because I could certainly use it. Metis definitely needs it. Okay, Junpei's just using Fire Break. Metis, you're not helping. Augudine, again on Junpei. Ow. And turret shot on Metis, which didn't actually do all that much. Okay, let's focus on getting rid of these things. If I can get rid of them, then I can safely bring back Yukari. Okay. That unfortunately doesn't do all that much. And Junpei, if you're gonna use Fire Break, maybe follow it up with Agilao. Okay, one of them's almost dead. Ah, crap. Oh, double crap. Ow, that hurt a lot. Okay. So, just in case the worst happens, Loki would actually be a terrible, terrible move. Takarabia can't really do all that much. Kumakuten's terrible. Goomba Hydra actually wouldn't be bad. I'm pretty sure I could survive an attack. Like, one mind-charged Augudine. It's just a matter of could I survive the Slaughter Drive's other attack if he chooses to target me. I mean, none of us are gonna survive anything if I don't heal, so... I'm just gonna have to risk it with Thor. Bring everyone else back up to full. And then hopefully have Junpei and Metis take out the Slaughter Drive. Oh, almost. Oh crap. Wow, that actually wasn't bad. Oh, this is gonna hurt. Okay. Things are looking all right. I don't think Junpei or Metis could take it out in a single hit, though. So I think I'm good to heal up everyone. And then I can bring back Yukari. Yeah, there's no way we can take it out. We do a good amount of damage to it. Yeah. Oh, I haven't even analyzed it. I think I was too preoccupied with them straight up murdering Yukari that I completely forgot to analyze him. Okay, let's bring her back. Then we can see about taking him out. Damn it. All right. Oh. Well, there we go. All right, sister. Let's get him. Weak to ice. Should have figured as much. Get all on attack and not quite summon. Ah, crap.
Defeat it.
Okay. He needs to die. He really needs to die.
Persona!
Okay, tank down. So all that's left is another Slaughter Drive.
That one just won't die.
Okay, so... unfortunately, with its evadal... Unfortunately, with its evade electricity, it's... gonna make my job quite a bit harder.
I need your help.
But
the enemy's off balance. Attack.
Here's a chance.
I'm gonna opt not for the all-out attack. And instead. Unfortunately, I mean Junpei and Metis are going to attack it regardless. So what I'll do, let's see, I could try, actually no, that wouldn't be a good move. Do I have any other personas with buff skills? Matarunda. The answer to that is no. No, I don't. Well, I can hit it with another Zeodine. It's like, I did not think this through. But if Junpei could maybe get a crit. There we go.
Here's a chance. Let's get
now we can go for the all-out attack. Okay, that actually worked out a lot better than I thought.
Dude, I gotta pull it together.
Alright, and we get Infernal Armor. And I leveled up. And Jutta, you leveled up. Hey. All right, but at the very least, I wasn't right in my assumption that we could take on the boss with very little trouble, actually. I mean, Yukari was down for most of that, but not counting that. For our reward, we get 2 attack mirrors and a precious egg. All right. So that's another barrier taken down. I was going to just jump to the Velvet Room, but I decided to head back to make sure Thor leveled up. He was like 900 experience points from leveling up. And getting his final skill, Elec Amp. Good as that is, I don't think I'll keep that. But I will, however, take that item. And we get the lightning gloves. Oh, sweet, Melchizedek also leveled up. Nice, that's a good bonus. Alright, now that we've got the item from Thor, now we can head back into the Velvet Room and see what we can do for fusions. So give me a minute while I see what all we can make. Now this is a combination I can get behind. So we are fusing away Loki, Throne, and Thoth in order to fuse Lilith. I'm eventually gonna get that persona with all the dying spells. Lilith is one step in the right direction. Much more powerful magic user. That is certainly a welcome addition to my team. I think I found my new opening persona from now on for bosses. At least for a while. So, we are fusing away Kumbahanda, Komokuten, and Thor in order to fuse Alice. These inherited skills are something that I expect on, oh, I don't know, Thanatos? Oh well. I'll happily accept them on Alice, though. That is certainly something that I am more than willing to accept. It's Alice. Alright, I think I am looking pretty good in terms of my personas. I've got a new opening persona now. So that's nice. Although I still have some items to get. Oh well, all in due time. So that will do it for this episode. Next time on Let's Play Persona 3 FES. We continue our exploration. We've only just scratched the surface of the Judeca block, but we are definitely drilling our way through. Not quite sure how long this block will be, but hopefully we can keep at it at the pace we're going now. If we keep it at this rate, we should be through the block in no time. So until next time, everyone, take care.